On August 24th, 2001, the flight was cruising high above the Atlantic Ocean, en route from Toronto to Lisbon. It was supposed to be just another overnight flight. 8 hours across the ocean, carrying 293 passengers and 13 crew members to Portugal's sunny coast. But somewhere, over the vast and empty stretch of water, something went terribly wrong. Most were asleep, unaware that their plane was gliding silently through the night sky, with no power, no fuel, and nowhere to land. The clock was ticking, and it was too late. By the time the pilots realized what was happening, both engines had failed.
You ever seen something like this before?
Nope. Never.
The aircraft was now gliding powerless, heavy, and rapidly descending with no nearby airports, no thrust, and hundreds of lives hanging in the balance. In the darkness, 39,000 feet above the ocean, it became a test of human instinct, mechanical endurance, and pure luck. How did a plane lose all its fuel midair without anyone noticing? How did the pilots manage to glide a wide-body jet for nearly 75 miles? Did they make it? This is the terrifying story of Air Transat Flight 236. On August 24th, 2001, Air Transat Flight 236 took off from Toronto, Canada, heading to Lisbon, Portugal. It was supposed to be a regular overnight flight across the Atlantic Ocean. Nothing unusual, nothing dramatic. The flight would cross eastern Canada, then soar over the open waters of the North Atlantic. It would pass near the Azores, those remote Portuguese islands in the middle of the ocean, before finally descending into Lisbon. The plane, an Airbus A330, was fairly new and in good shape. There were families, tourists, business travelers, all hoping to sleep through the night and wake up in Europe. The evening in Toronto was calm. At the airport, people hugged their loved ones. Some waved goodbye through the glass, while others wiped away quiet tears. For the passengers, this was just another chapter in their lives. No one had any reason to feel uneasy. Inside the cockpit, the two pilots were getting ready. Captain Robert Pichet was a seasoned flyer, known for staying calm under pressure. His co-pilot, Dirk de Jager, was young but sharp. Together, they had everything under control. But what no one knew, not the pilots, not the passengers, was that deep inside the plane, a slow and silent disaster had already begun. And soon, that peaceful night would turn into one of the most terrifying flights in aviation history. Before we begin, if you enjoy true stories of survival, aviation mysteries, and dramatic rescues, make sure to hit that subscribe button. The flight took off from Toronto at 0052 UTC, 2052 ET on Thursday, August 23rd. The aircraft had been in service for just 2 years and was well equipped to handle the transatlantic journey. All seemed well as they ascended into the night sky. As the flight ascended, passengers settled in for the long haul. The aircraft climbed smoothly through the clouds and continued on its course, cruising at a high altitude. In the cockpit, the crew was going through their usual checks, maintaining constant communication with air traffic control and ensuring everything was operating normally. For the first 4 hours, the flight was uneventful, as is often the case on long-distance international flights. The aircraft passed over Canada, heading toward the open waters of the North Atlantic, where the airspace was quieter and navigation was mostly on autopilot. The routine continued until 0438 UTC, nearly 4 hours into the flight. At this point, the right engine, labeled as engine number 2, began to experience an unusual issue. The engine started leaking fuel through a fracture that had developed in its fuel line. At first, the problem was small, hardly noticeable to the crew or anyone on board, but over time, the fuel began to escape steadily. At 0503 UTC, just 25 minutes later, the crew was alerted to a new problem. The aircraft's fuel system monitoring system showed an unusual pattern, a significant drop in fuel levels. By now, the fuel imbalance between the two engines was evident. Captain Pichet and First Officer de Jager had no immediate idea that this was caused by the fuel leak. The crew saw oil pressure and oil temperature warnings for the right engine, but they didn't immediately link these indicators to the fuel issue. Instead, the crew suspected false warnings. They believed these readings might have been caused by some other non-critical issue. As the situation unfolded, the pilots contacted Air Transat's maintenance control in Montreal, updating them on the situation. The Montreal team suggested the crew monitor the situation and continue the flight while keeping an eye on the readings. But they didn't yet grasp the gravity of the situation. This moment was the critical point where Flight 236 had unknowingly passed the point of no return. The combination of the fuel leak, which was being exacerbated by the fuel flow adjustments on the aircraft, and the misinterpretation of early warning signals set the stage for what was to come. Adding to the confusion, the trim tank, which is meant to balance the fuel load during flight, began to transfer fuel prematurely. This transfer was intended to balance the fuel on board, but the rate at which it was done was far too fast for the amount of fuel they had. This was part of the fuel imbalance problem that became evident around 0536 UTC. The fuel imbalance warning appeared, but again, the pilots, relying on memory rather than official procedures, mishandled the situation. In fact, instead of using the checklists that should have guided their response, the crew acted on their own, transferring fuel from one tank to another. Unfortunately, this only exacerbated the problem. The fuel was being lost through the fractured fuel line at a rapid rate, around 13 tons per hour, more than 3.6 kilograms per second. And much of the fuel transferred into the system was immediately lost through the crack in the fuel line. This loss wasn't just a drop in fuel levels. It had a cascading effect on the aircraft's oil flow. By now, the pilots had no choice but to act fast, but they were beginning to realize the situation was far more dire than they initially thought. The rapid fuel loss meant that engine number 2 was now consuming fuel at a higher than normal rate, which disrupted the fuel oil heat exchanger. This caused oil temperature to drop and oil pressure to rise, signaling that the engine was in trouble. By 0545 UTC, the pilots made a crucial decision. They needed to divert to the nearest airport. They chose Lages Air Base in the Azores. It is a small island group in the middle of the Atlantic. However, their heading became misaligned due to an issue with the autopilot, which had been set to true heading mode instead of the correct magnetic heading. Despite this, the crew corrected their course and began to communicate with Santa Maria Oceanic Air Traffic Control.
Mayday! Mayday!
By then, they were in full-blown emergency mode, with the fuel emergency officially declared just minutes after the heading was corrected. At 0613 UTC, with the aircraft still 170 miles away from the Azores and flying at 39,000 feet, disaster struck. Engine number 2 flamed out. Fuel starvation had caused the engine to shut down. This forced Captain Pichet to initiate a descent to 33,000 feet to find a safe altitude for their single operating engine. A few minutes later, at 0626 UTC, while still about 75 miles from Lages Air Base, the unthinkable happened. Engine number 1 also flamed out, leaving the aircraft with no power from either engine. This left the pilots with no primary electrical power and no source of bleed air for cabin pressurization. Without engine power, the aircraft was left gliding in the sky with only a limited amount of control. The emergency ram air turbine, RAT, deployed automatically, providing just enough hydraulic pressure to control the primary flight controls. However, without functioning engines, the flaps, brakes, and spoilers were useless. The plane's descent was steady, but the pilots knew they were running out of time. The altitude was rapidly decreasing, and they had no choice but to rely on the guidance of military air traffic controllers, who helped navigate them to the airbase using their radar system. Military controllers advised the crew to perform S-turns and a 360-degree turn to dissipate excess altitude as the aircraft slowly drifted towards the runway. The descent rate was high, about 2,000 feet per minute, and they were now rapidly approaching a critical point. It was clear that without power or control, they would be forced to ditch in the ocean unless they could make it to the airbase in time. At 0645 UTC, the crew finally saw the runway of Lages Air Base. With no engines to slow them down, Captain Pichet executed a hard landing, coming down about 1,030 feet past the runway threshold. The plane's speed was around 200 knots, 370 kilometers per hour, and it bounced once before touching down again, about 2,800 feet from the runway's threshold. Despite the lack of working anti-skid and brake modulation systems, the crew applied maximum emergency braking. But the locked-up wheels were already fully deflated, and the plane slid to a stop after covering 7,600 feet of the 10,000-foot runway. The structural damage was significant. The main landing gear was severely damaged from the hard touchdown, and the fuselage was punctured from debris shed by the wheels. Fortunately, the evacuation was relatively smooth. However, there were injuries. 14 passengers and two crew members suffered minor injuries, while two passengers were more seriously hurt during the evacuation. So, what went wrong and how the pilots pulled off that incredible landing? Hit the subscribe button and stay tuned. The investigation into Air Transat Flight 236 revealed some shocking details. The fuel leak that caused the crisis was no accident. It was the result of poor decisions in maintenance and the flight crew's response. It all started with the spare engine. Air Transat had to replace the engine with one from an older model, but the hydraulic part used to make it fit wasn't the right match. This led to a dangerous problem. The fuel line and hydraulic line rubbed against each other, eventually causing the fuel line to rupture and leak. But here's the main part. Despite the concerns of the lead mechanic, Air Transat authorized the use of that part. A small mistake, but one that had catastrophic consequences. Air Transat took responsibility for the incident and was fined a record $250,000. But the pilots? They became heroes. Their skillful, unpowered landing saved 293 lives. Captain Pichet was even awarded the Superior Airmanship Award for his calm under pressure. The pilots of Air Transat Flight 236 showed what true bravery looks like, facing unimaginable challenges in the sky and bringing their passengers safely to the ground. If you found this story interesting, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and drop a comment down below with your thoughts. And hey, share this video with your friends. Let's spread these incredible stories. Until next time, stay tuned for more aircraft mysteries and survival stories. See you in the next one.